If you've been around the Next world for even a short while, chances are you've already come across the cat command. Cat is short for concatenate and is used to display the contents of one or more files without having to open them for editing. We're finally going to talk about redirect operators, also look at a bunch of useful examples with pipes to a few other commands, and after that I'm going to show you a simple but fun little steganography trick. Welcome to Nick's Tricks, I am Nick and this is not a cat video. How's it going, guys? Let's get the basics out of the way. So, what is concatenation? To concatenate means to combine or join things together. When you concatenate two strings of text, you get a longer string. Concatenate two files, you're getting a file that contains the contents of both files merged together. This is all going to make sense once we see some examples. So, with this concept in mind, we can now look at the basic syntax of the cat command and understand how it works right away. The command page says it can concatenate files and print them onto the standard output. This means we can type cat followed by a file, and we'll see the contents of the file displayed as the command output. It's as basic as that. Our only input was that one file, so the result of concatenating it was the very same file, because something plus nothing is the same original something. But similarly, we can pass two files to our command and it will display the contents of both of them one after another, effectively concatenating them. One step further, you can use globs to pass in multiple files at once. Globs are patterns or wildcards that are used to match file names or paths, and I just got an idea for my next video. So if you do want to know more about globs, you can subscribe and hit the bell to catch next week's video where I'm going over all the glob characters, what they're for and how to use them efficiently with various shell commands. Back to our cat. We've seen that it can take in one or multiple files, but it can also take in no files at all. If you don't specify any files, it'll read from the standard input. That means that you can use your keyboard as the input interactively. This is especially useful if you need to create a file in an environment that doesn't provide a text editor. The syntax goes like cat followed by nothing or a single dash character. That's a placeholder used to represent standard input, followed by a right angle bracket. That's a basic redirect operator, and then the name of the file that we want to write to. From this point on, anything we type is being stored in a buffer. We can press enter to go on to the next line, and all of this text is just waiting to be dumped inside of that file. To save the contents of the file, we need to send an EOF or end of file signal to cat. This will indicate the end of the input stream, and we can do that by pressing Ctrl D. You just witnessed the power of the output redirect operator. The text that we created interactively got redirected to a file that is now storing it for us. Let's play around with the text files that we have around here. We can use the redirect operator to send the contents of a single file to another file. That is basically copying it. If the destination file doesn't exist, it'll be created. If it does, it will be overwritten, so always be mindful of that when redirecting. Of course, it can be more useful to redirect multiple files to a single target. This can come in handy, for instance, if you want to do some text processing or analysis on a bunch of sort of similar types of files like rotated logs from a process over a number of days or the files with a specific extension from a project directory. It's very likely that I'm also going to make a video about redirects and pipelines soon, but for now I do have to mention another type of redirect operator. The double right angle bracket is used for appending output. You can use it to add stuff to an existing file without overwriting it, but instead appending it to the existing content. Another example where I'm appending the contents of one of the files, then some standard input from my keyboard followed by yet another file. Didn't even mention any of the options that we have available. It's not many of them, so let's just go quickly over all of them. Dash S to suppress repeated empty lines. Dash N to show all line numbers. Dash B is the same as N, but it skips the black lines. Dash V displays all the non-printing characters. Dash capital E will display all the end line symbols. Dash lowercase e is the equivalent of lowercase v uppercase e. Dash capital T to display tab characters. Lowercase t is the equivalent of v capital T. And dash capital A to show all. That's v capital E capital T. Before we check out some common pipes, I have to mention the tac command. That's cat backwards, and as the name suggests, it concatenates and prints files in reverse. It's good to know about it and not need it than to need it and not know about it. Now, I'd like to show you a few other useful commands in rapid fire, not getting into any details, just building some useful pipelines. The first one is more. You can use it to basically add page breaks to long text outputs. Normally, cat would quickly output everything at once and a terminal would scroll the way down, but the more command adds pagination to the output, so you can press space for the next page or enter for the next line. If you prefer a more granular control, you can use less instead, where you can navigate using the arrows on your keyboard or the page up and down keys or even some of the typical Vim controls. There are also a couple of commands named head and tail that we can use to grab only the first or last few lines from a file. By default, without any arguments, this number of lines is 10, but we can add a dash and a number to specify how many lines we want. That's a shorthand for the n option. It's a convenient way to pass in that argument, but knowing the full syntax may help in case of limited support somewhere. We still have a bit of time for that steganography trick I mentioned. In cybersec, steganography is the technique of hiding secret data within ordinary non-secret files or messages in order to avoid detection. This is not to be confused with stenography, which is the process of transcribing in shorthand, the kind of stuff you see in courtrooms. This is really basic. The way it works is you concatenate a binary file and one or more other files, making sure that the binary file comes first. That can be anything, an image or audio or video file, it doesn't matter. The header of the file will contain all the necessary metadata and specific format details about the file, so the operating system will use the appropriate instructions to open a file normally. But since the file does contain additional information at the end, you can inspect that using cat or any text editor. The important note here is that this method does not provide any encryption. It's just a way to illustrate this concept. There are dedicated tools out there that can do this properly. You can let me know in the comments if you think that would be interesting to see in a future video maybe. But for now, congrats for going through yet another super essential Linux command, and congrats to me for going through an entire video without a single cat meme. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.